Welcome back to the Azure Cosmos DB Essential Series. My name is Mustafa. I am the Portfolio PMM for Azure Cosmos DB. In this season, we're joined by Mark Brown, a PM on the Azure Cosmos DB product team. This season, we want to take use cases a step further and dive into some of the architectures customers are using to build lightweight applications. In the last three episodes, we covered real-time telemetry, a product catalog, and an order processing solution. In this episode, we want to focus more broadly on how we can take full advantage of distributed NoSQL by globally distributing our apps.
Azure Cosmos DB is a distributed NoSQL database. In order to provide the advantages of high availability that comes with being a distributed database, we keep four copies of users' data across four replicas within a replica set in each region. And we provide replication to every Azure region worldwide. This does two things. First, it reduces the latency of reads for users by bringing the data closer to them. The less distance data must travel, the faster it can get there, and that provides greater performance. The second thing is it provides for greater availability. Data that is replicated in multiple regions can survive events where a region may become unavailable, such as when a network connectivity is lost or a natural disaster occurs. So data replication increases availability and improves read performance by bringing data closer to users. Users can also enjoy greater write performance when enabling a feature called multi-region writes. This effectively allows every regional read replica to accept writes, making those faster now too. Data written into any region is then merged and replicated to every other configured region.
So how about we dive into the architecture and start to sort through some of the details? Let's start with Azure Traffic Manager. What does Azure Traffic Manager do?
Azure Traffic Manager is a DNS load balancer. It routes traffic from end users to regional endpoints into your applications deployed within those regions. Traffic Manager routes your traffic based upon the routing method used. You can choose from many, including priority, round robin, weighted, geographic, performance, and others. If we were to go with the performance routing method, we could, for instance, route users to the endpoint that offers the lowest network latency. But there are some instances where we may not want that, and there are other configurations, such as geographic, which will route users to specific endpoints based upon the geographic location where those requests originate. This is most often used when there are data sovereignty restrictions in place where traffic cannot leave a specific country. Now, if we were pointing to three endpoints, say A, B, and C, what we're going to do is have an instance of Cosmos DB in each of those regions.
In practice, we may have two, four, or N regions, right? But for the sake of the example, it makes sense to focus on three. So walk us through how this configuration is going to actually improve availability.
Right. So let's say region A goes down. If we are using the performance routing method, when region A becomes unavailable, traffic will be routed to either the B or C regions, depending on which of those is faster. So all requests will go to those two regions, onto then the corresponding Cosmos DB instance in those regions. When region A comes back online, requests will be routed back to it, and things will return to normal.
So I can see how something like Traffic Manager can help with availability for both the user and the application's front end. Are there other ways in which this type of multi-region deployment, where you have both the front end and the database in each region, can help with greater availability?
Yeah, definitely. There are, in fact, multiple places where connectivity or availability might be lost. You could lose connectivity within a region between an application's front end and the database, or Cosmos DB itself may lose availability within a single region. In scenarios like that, the front end in the region where that occurs can simply redirect its request to the next closest region where there's a database deployed. The SDK client in Cosmos DB maintains a list of network latencies between regions. So when it fails over to another region, it knows out of those regions you have configured for the account, which is the next closest region to retry the request on. Best of all, this happens automatically and quite quickly. The only thing users may notice is their application requests are taking slightly longer now. And this is due to the application's front end in that region now making requests in another region to the database. And as before, once that region is restored, the SDK client will reconnect and everything will go back to the way it was before.
Thanks so much, Mark. And thanks everyone for joining. That wraps up the last episode of season 3. We hope you learned something and look forward to seeing you next time.